Hi guys, welcome to the part 3 of this match play match with myself and Rick Shields at in our golf club, and it is beautiful and sunny. The match is all square and we are going into three final holes that could define us both as humans and as golfers.
Yeah, so we 7, 8 and 9 left to go. We're having a little Portugal match series, so we've done 5 9 hole matches now.
Yeah, so yeah.
You're 3.5, I'm 1.5 points up. So this is crucial for me. I need to win these last three to pull this match back. It's a par four that sweeps up to the right hand side. Might just be able to make out the pin right up there in the top corner.
And with the wind, I think we've got to start it as soon as we can over these trees, really.
Yeah. Wind's hurting off the right, so hitting a fade off this tee is the normal option, but with the wind hurting off the right, restricts that option.
It's gonna go as far right as I dare with this 3-wood.
It's a nice shot.
Yeah. Happy with that.
That is a nice shot.
Sit down. Sit. Just run into the semi, I think.
I think I'm going to go more right.
I think you can afford to. I went right over, I'm sure Shot Trace will show, right over the corner of that tree, and the wind's taking it the left-hand side of the fairway there. So definitely could have gone a wee bit more. It's been actually a good quality match this, apart from one hole.
But are we including that?
I think I'm gonna have to.
Am I in Shot Trace?
Yes you are, I've just moved it around. Yeah guys, if you watch part two, Rick was, he actually had me up against a tree and was like, listen, you will take that all out. And I was like, I can't do it. The people want to see it.
Right, at least we're both horrendous on that hole.
Yeah, it's true.
Hit it, wind.
Hit it. It's all well. It just depends where it's finished, but I don't know how far the trees go. It did not move at all.
So we got down here, Pete's on the left. We've not looked at my ball just yet, but it's up the right hand side. Hopefully got lucky.
Right, I've got 100 yards.
Uh oh.
Historically,
I don't like it when Pete's got 100 yards.
Historically, this is the one. The only problem is I've got that.
Thank God.
So I'm going to have to take it slightly right.
I think the wind's helping though.
Yeah, I'm going to have to take it slightly right.
The branches there that he's. Normally, if it was at like full sand wedge, you'd probably get over them branches, but with pitching wedge, you'd probably be perfect flight. So he's going to start it just in this little window up here. Wind's not hurt it at all. Surprised, actually, because when you started that off, I was thinking, uh-oh.
I thought I'd hit it.
Uh-oh.
Really good, that.
Right, let's go and head over to my...
Well, this is a rather big potential moving point in this match.
Oh, my goodness. Not what I wanted.
I mean, Rick has a gap. So, on the positive side, he has a gap. But, well, actually, no. In fairness, you've got two gaps.
I think that's my gap.
Yeah, you've got a choice of going under this tree, over that tree with a draw, or literally a low...
Just realise what you've just said. What? You've got to go under this tree, over that tree with a draw... Sand wedge out of a bare lie, 100 yards.
Yeah, this is YouTube. You know where you're at. It might be... I think another option for you is like a low hooky 9-iron. Try and pitch it before the bunker. And almost like springboard it over, but... That's more of a risky play, I'd say, than what you're trying to do.
I think I'm going to go in that window there.
Yeah.
A drawy one in that window.
Come on, be
if
a master.
Turning, and in that window, the wind's going to help it. Pitch on top near yours, and it just goes.
If you didn't hear that, I'll translate. Rick's going to try and hit it through that gap, and when it lands on the green, it should zoom with the wind to the left.
Oh my goodness.
Make it happen.
Come on, Chelsea. This is your moment.
Oh, it's got through. Is it coming back?
No.
Very good. That's an excellent shot from there.
I'm surprised it didn't turn a bit more, actually, just with the breeze even.
Yeah, that's an excellent shot. Okay, up to the green. Rick is just off the side. I'm just on. A little bit past, even if mine had drawn back, it would have finished beyond the pin. So I'm putting pretty much straight downhill, I think, from where I am. Rick's got to come up onto the green. You got it coming from your right?
Just a bit.
Just a little bit.
So these are...
So these are both 4-3. Wind is picking up a little bit as well. The sun's out there, that's nice. Warming up the arms and the body. That's going to come down nicely. Very good.
It's a little bit softy on them.
Well, the greens are fast. Take that one away. I mean, the greens are quick though, so.
I just feel like I'm being a little bit softy. I need to be a bit more committal on that line. Because aim point, really, you've got to be hitting it 9, 12 inches past. I'm not trying to drop it in.
I'm not sure what the... I think Jamie was saying that you'll adapt it to how you feel as well. It's not like a... It's not a one-stop shop.
No.
Oh, wow. Have some swing on this bad boy.
Sure is. I was kind of actually probably going to move the flag, to be fair, but you put it in quite a
precarious position.
I don't want you using that flag for any markers either.
Too late.
So this is honestly going to start like up here somewhere. It's going to move quick.
Depends how brave I want to be getting it to the apex of the slope, but it's going to come round.
Looking tidy, it's looking tidy.
Do it, do straight away. So aggressive.
Very difficult from there though, not much more you could really do. I don't know how you would have actually died it from there.
I mean, on the positive, I know what he's going to do on the way back. Damn it.
It's a par putt to stay level in the match. This is a big moment. Wow.
Toe-y pull.
Oh. Right, Rick goes one up, two to play. Didn't expect that. But these greens have got hidden shelves that can punish a mere anyone, really. Right, two holes to go. One in it. Let's get on to the eighth. Okay, we move now into the eighth hole. Beautiful little par three down the hill here. Pin is just in there. 1-3, what did we say it was?
1-3-3.
Are you going to go with?
Wedge.
I think wedge is the call.
That wind's just like moving around everywhere.
It's definitely down a little bit, but it's also off the right. I think a shot which finishes just beyond the pin.
Beyond the pin.
Yeah, may spin back as well. Oh, God. So frustrated. I'm going to have to calm my adrenaline on the next shot. Come on, wind. It's coming a wee bit. Oh, no. I think that got in your head then. You was too soft on that.
If I had wedge, I tried to hit it hard.
Really?
If I'd have gone 9, I'd have hit it soft. So that's in the water.
That looked like a soft swing, that.
Well, that is in the water.
Right, okay.
Wow. Wow, all things are going on now.
This is a dramatic final part. I've got a wedge. I still think it's wedge.
You might just hit it a bit harder now. This is too hard, but that's going top left.
That's going to be a fun old putt from up there.
Oh my goodness. Real fun putt.
Okay. So Rick's got it. It is just... Oh, wow. Okay.
Check out this traction on these shoes.
It is just about playable. I'm going to come back a little bit and use my zoom just so I can capture the full magic if Rick has a wee bit of an overbalance.
Right on the edge. How deep is it?
Well, the water... it's not super deep, but I reckon it'll get knee-high.
I can just get my toe in.
Pins are just there, by the way.
Okay, that's toe in.
Okay.
Wonderfully waterproof, these shoes. Oh. Right. Oh, no, they're not. I've got up to laces. I got up to laces.
Oh, no, they're not.
Well, they are. I just got up to laces.
Well, looks like we're going to be heading down the last hole square.
Ninth hole and the final hole in this match.
All square.
Wow. I did that for drama.
Yeah, this part has had it all so far. Guys, if you're watching, Rick obviously did that on purpose.
I was just saying to Pete, you know, obviously I'm a team player.
It's much appreciated. Right, this is about 360 yards, I think.
360, down and off the right wind.
Just time for a launchy Rui, isn't it? Tee it high and then let it hopefully fly relatively straight.
Oh, that has been bombed.
Nah, it's not.
No?
Nah.
You sure? It kind of looks like he got on the green.
If that's got on the green, I'll be very, very surprised. Because that was very high off the face.
I think high, low spin.
Unless he has got that magic effect. But when I struck it, it didn't feel good. I have to say, though, I reckon you could get close if you give it a good old biff. Okay, here we go. Time to say bye-bye, ball.
I hope not. I hope I find it again.
Oh yeah, onto the green, like. Here we go. Awesome. That's a fantastic fly. Go on. Fly, 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 fly. That ain't going to be far away. Just slightly left, but very good. Well, we get down to the green and I am surprised I almost hit it on the front edge. Because when he came out, when he was in flight, I think he was just high off the face, no spin.
I thought it was really good, but...
Yeah, I mean, I don't normally hit it that high off the face when I mean to. So, just a happy combination. So we both, well, chip and a putt really to win, or a chip and a putt to half, or a chip and two putts if someone really, really has a shocker.
Or a chip in.
Or a chip in, pitch in, eagle. That'd be a nice way to finish. 60?
Wind's playing with my head.
Okay, gonna have a little bit of a recharge, refocus. Nipped it. Stop. Stop. A little bit
in my head, I couldn't play that any better.
Thought it was all right. Maybe tiny bit clean, maybe, but I don't know. I thought it was all right.
Thought it would have stopped quicker, if I'm honest.
Interesting. That's in mine.
Okay, so we get down to the green, and it has run on, I must admit, but I think a lot of that to do with the downwind was really throwing my head around. I couldn't figure out how quick it was going to stop, so it's not horrendous, but my fear is how good Pete is from this range. He's typically very, very good. this green a bit harder.
How annoying.
I mean, I'll be honest with you though, it was confident.
I struck it awesome.
This green just seems a little bit harder than the rest. Some of them have been quite receptive so far. So, two birdie putts from the back of the green here now. Just on Pete, which I didn't expect to say.
Well, I think what you'll find I was trying to do, everyone, is, you know, the old Sebi.
Getting the hole first.
Get it in first.
I'll come around this side so you can see the beautiful clubhouse as well. We didn't really have time to get in there before. We quickly ran in on our arrival. It looks stunning, very new as well. I don't know how new it actually is. Anyway, down the hill. A little bit left to right.
Aim point says right to left.
Okay, I'm going to stick with that then. For birdie to put the pressure on.
I'd have been fuming if I hadn't birdied that.
I'm not going to be honest with you, I'm freaking fuming.
You did birdie it.
Tell you what though, again, because I'm with you, looking at it, left to right all day. That was not left to right. Aim point said, Peter, you need to rethink what you're doing. Because aim point is, well, American, and he's obviously lived in Sweden for a while with that accent.
Can't believe you've just done that.
So this, to all square up the match. Nothing to lose.
Nothing to lose,
you say? Well, nothing to lose because it's in or nothing. It's in or I'm taking everything. I'm taking it home. I'm going to take it downtown. I'm going to take it dancing.
You can't believe
it. Buy a few cocktails.
Forget that, Rick. Forget it.
It's been a rather dramatic last few holes. Come on. Come on. Let's get it in. Get it in. Get it in. Got it. He's got it. Yes. What a putt.
My goodness.
You know, well, that's the type of finish that I want to be seeing.
Right,
awesome.
Now we're both happy.
Brilliant. Both happy. Awesome stuff. Right, guys. Thank you so much for watching. That part was, well, a lot more dramatic than I think either of us wanted, but it's ended up with a half. So that takes the standings to 4-2.
No real gain, unfortunately.
No, 4-2 in total. It's been an amazing front nine here. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for Pinar for having us down. Course is beautiful. Loving these trees, despite how horrible they are when they gobble up balls. Please subscribe to the channel. Make sure you subscribe to Rick as well. Follow us also on our social media platforms. And we'll hop over to Rick's channel now.
Play the back nine.
For more competition.